Hi, pleasure meeting you all. Today we'll discuss about the basic outline of the anatomy of the pulp cavity, which includes a pulp cavity, pulp chamber, root canal and root canal orifices. Before starting the root canal treatment, if you want to master the root canal treatment, every clinician should know the anatomy of the pulp cavity in detail. So let's start the session. Pulp cavity. What is pulp cavity? Pulp cavity is nothing but a central cavity which is present in the center of the tooth, enclosed completely by dentin all around except at the apical foramen. But suppose if we consider the anterior teeth, this is a pulp cavity which is enclosed by a dentin all around. Except at the apical foramen, through which the blood vessels and nerves enters the tooth into the pulp cavity, right? This is enamel, dentin and pulp cavity. The pulp cavity is divided into coronal off and radicular off. Coronal off is called as a pulp chamber, whereas radicular off is called as root canal. In case of anterior teeth, the pulp chamber converges or merges at the CSA and continues as a root canal. There is no much demarcation between the pulp chamber and root canal. If you observe in a multi-rooted teeth, this is a pulp chamber and these are root canals and these are root canal orifices. These enamel, dentin and pulp. The pulp cavity in the posterior teeth is divided into pulp chamber and root canal. These root canal orifices are clearly demarcated in the posterior tooth, that means the multi-rooted tooth, whereas in anterior root there is no much demarcation between the pulp chamber and root canal orifices. The root canal orifices are always located at the CEJ. So I repeat, pulp cavity is a closed space which is present in the center of the tooth, which is enclosed by dentin all around except the apical foramen, through which the blood vessel and nerves enters the tooth, right? It is divided into a coronal off and a radicular off. A coronal off is called as a pulp chamber, whereas a radicular off is called as a root canal. In anterior tooth, there is no much demarcation between the pulp chamber and a root canal, whereas in multi-rooted tooth, there is a clear demarcation between the pulp chamber and the root canal. At the junction of the pulp chamber and root canal, at the level of CEJ, you can find a root canal orifices, pulp chamber. As I mentioned earlier, this is the coronal portion of the pulp cavity. Imagine this room as a pulp chamber, which has a roof, floor and four different walls, the mesial, distal, buccal and lingual. The roof of the pulp chamber is formed by a dentin covering the pulp chamber occlusally and incisally. Whereas the floor of the pulp chamber runs parallel to the roof of the pulp chamber and which in turn formed by dentin abounding the cervical area of the tooth. Particularly if you want to mention, this is a dentin in the furcation area. Or suppose imagine this cube as a pulp chamber. Right? It has roof. This is called a roof of the pulp chamber. This is a floor of the pulp chamber. Always the floor of the pulp chamber is darker in color when compared to its adjacent walls. Pulp horn is nothing but accentuation or extension of the roof of the pulp chamber directly under the cusp or any prominence. To make it simple, it's nothing but the extension of the pulp under any prominence like a cusp. This is the pulp chamber. The root canal orifices. Root canals. The extension of the pulp chamber beneath any cusp or a prominence. So these are called as pulp horns. These are mesial pulp horn and these a distal pulp horn. Right? This is a mesial side and this is a distal side. Pulp horn is nothing but a direct extension of the pulp under a prominence, nothing but a cusp. Always remember, the mesial pulp horn is located a little bit higher when compared to a distal pulp horn. If you observe this radiograph, you can clearly appreciate that the mesial pulp horn is above the distal pulp horn. The walls of the pulp chamber derive their names from the adjacent walls. I mean, but suppose this is the mesial surface and this is the distal surface and this is the buccal and lingual. We will name the walls of the pulp chamber according to the different surface of a tube. That means the wall which is present towards the mesial side is called a mesial wall of pulp chamber, whereas distal side a distal wall of pulp chamber, on the lingual side a lingual wall of pulp chamber, and the buccal side is called as a buccal wall of pulp chamber. In the same way, the angles of the pulp chamber derive their name from the adjacent walls of the tooth. That is a mesobuccal angle of the pulp chamber, and this is the mesial surface and there is the lingual surface. This is the mesolingual angle of the pulp chamber, whereas this is the distobuccal and this is a distolingual, right? Root canal orifices are not a separate entity. They are in continuation with the pulp chamber and located at the level of the CEJ and continues in the radicular portion as a root canal. The exact location of the pulp chamber or the root canal orifices given by a Krasner and Ramko in the set of 9 guidelines. Just go and refer to one of my previous videos, Laws of Root Canal Orifice Location.